the fact that, like, all the years I was trying to run different businesses and failing, it was basically just supported from afar, not really, you know, getting too involved. He was working, making his money, etc. And he saw that I was struggling to take that engineering degrees and use it. Put it at the time I was putting it on to make and try to sell it. That was the original version of Njoku. Buy movies in Nigeria, have someone send them to me in the UK, put them onto eBay as a store and try to sell it. That didn't work at all. And then there was one lady from a Ghanaian lady who used to buy stuff from me in the UK. So he was like, why don't you try to put it on YouTube? It never occurred to me. What I didn't realize was that what was required to get onto YouTube was me having to come to Nigeria. And he bought my ticket, I didn't have any money, so he bought my ticket. I came to Nigeria. We paid the producers a little bit of money, whatever we had available to us. And again, it wasn't my money, it was his money. And we had no idea. So from the moment of, I want to do something in Nigeria, entertainment space in 2009, to us actually launching on YouTube, that was 18 months. 18 months. And I lived in my mother's house. In my own bedroom, my mother harassing me, and she was deeply upset that I somehow failed in life at 30. And literally 18 hours a day, I used to work. Again, to the point where my people were like, what is it you're doing on this online day? Again, to the other guys who were members, there was no long-term girlfriend, there was nothing, it was just me and that my work. I realized that, you know, If I can't afford a woman, let me just fix my work, and then that will come later on. So, at the very, very early stages, I literally flew hundreds of hours a week, at least 100 hours a week, at this. I became obsessed about it. I think I understood it better than most people at the time, because I was just spending too much time on it. And the fact is, it took a really long time for IrokoTV to even look like it was a success. And when I mean look like it was a success, I mean like us making $60,000 every month. And that literally took 18 months, and my friend went on from giving £500, £10,000, £20,000. He ended up putting like £120,000 into IrokoTV in order to actually make it what it is today, essentially. Now, I never took that for granted. I was working so hard, so he always knew that I wasn't enjoying my life with his money. You can tell it on my body. I wasn't. Look, if you go back and look at my Facebook, you look at pictures today, and I wasn't like this. You know? He knew that I was working as hard as someone could. He knew that I was respectful of his money. And he knew that I wasn't willing to waste money on things which didn't make sense, didn't make any sense going forward. So I think at the early stages of anything, again, I'm not the smartest person, like, yeah, under no illusion I'm the smartest person. But if it's to work, I can outwork it. And I can outwork it over like really long periods of time. And I think if you're incredibly hard working and you take everything you do seriously, you will be successful. I don't know what degree of success you will be, but you will definitely be successful if you just work incredibly hard.
Alright. Thank you. Clap, 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 clap.